One of these two 3D models is more detailed than the other. Can you guess which? Yep, it's this one, a 3D model I downloaded online. But why? Obviously, Kratos from God of War looks much more detailed than this Hezrou from D&D. Well, I learned that the reason for that is extremely important for the game I'm developing. So, what exactly am I talking about? I've been developing a game that will allow you to play D&D online with a first-person perspective for close to... Jesus, 2 months now? And currently, I am developing a GM map creator that relies, among other things, on a 3D model importer, with the objective of allowing the GM to create whatever they want in the game, as long as they can find, make, or buy the necessary 3D model. It sounds like a neat little idea, since many artists already create these types of models for 3D printing, but I didn't take something into account, and that is game optimization. More specifically, the work that goes into optimizing the 3D models that you see during gameplay. And oh boy. To explain this, let's look at the basics. What is a 3D model? It is a digital representation of a 3D object, made up of a series of polygonal shapes. Polygons are shapes that, when combined with others, form a 3D object. And as a rule of thumb, the more polygons a model has, the more detailed and complex it becomes. Coming back to optimization, the number of polygons in a 3D model can affect the performance of a video game in several ways. And the more the detail, the more strain it puts on computers' resources. This can lead to slower frame rates, longer render times of stuff like lighting and physics, so a decreased overall performance. And that's why game developers often employ optimization techniques to balance the visual quality of their 3D models with the performance needs of their game. So, let's go back to the beginning of the video. Kratos and Hezrou, two different 3D models. I told you that this Hezrou model is more detailed than Kratos. The question now is, how much more detailed? Using polygons as our way of quantifying it, we know thanks to Sony that Kratos has 18,000 polygons. That's a big number. But Kratos is also one of the most detailed character models in recent memory. Now, looking at Hezrou, how many polygons do you think they have? Well, I won't make you wait. They have 100,000 polygons, times 10. Yep, this one model has 1 million polygons. A million! Sing we now, sing for the year, sing for the land, and sing for the tear. To be completely accurate, this model is 15 times more computationally expensive than the Kratos one. And this is true of many other files out there that are created specifically for 3D printing. They're simply not optimized for video games, because they don't need to. And how did I notice this? Well, because I was trying to create a map that I've had in mind for my ongoing campaign with my friends. And the moment I imported this Hezrou model, the frame rate completely tanked. Now, this is completely unacceptable performance-wise, and it poses a big challenge with my idea. So, if I want users to be able to have the freedom of using models found online, I can't expect all of them to be optimized for games. So I need a way of optimizing them inside my VTT. So, as the meta for this devlog, I want to implement a way of optimizing 3D models in runtime. Because if I don't, this project simply won't work. And if you're enjoying the video so far, please consider leaving a like. Well, in order to optimize a 3D model, developers use many techniques. But after searching for some myself, I decided to focus on two specific ways of doing it. One is LODs, and the other, mesh simplification. LOD, or level of detail, is one of those invisible game dev secrets that make all the difference. And when done right, you can't even notice it. Basically, this involves creating multiple versions of the same model, each with a different polygon count. The version with the highest polygon count is used when the model is close to the camera, while a lower count version is used when it's farther away. This helps to reduce the overall polygon count in the scene and improve performance by a lot. And mesh simplification involves reducing the number of polygons in a model while retaining its overall shape and form. Here I'm doing it on Blender, and the overall quality of the model stays the same. Oh no, too far! Too far! Okay. So, here is the difference between the base model and the simplified model. While the models are different for sure, the difference isn't astronomical like it is to the polygon count. The base one has 1 million and the simplified one has 20,000. Now, it's less than Kratos' face. Okay, so now we have an understanding of what I want the VTT to be able to do. Now, I just have to find a way to do it. I searched online for ways to make automatic LODs, because Unity has a LOD component that makes implementing it quite easy, but it requires me to already have less detailed models beforehand. So I'm not totally sure I would be able to automatically create LODs for imported 3D models. So for now, I set LODs aside and focused on mesh simplification, because through my search online, I found this free asset called Mesh Optimizer. Let's see. Optimize your high poly meshes into low poly in seconds. Well, I'll be damned. That's exactly what I'm looking for. After importing it and getting to grips with how it worked, I decided to test it out with the Hezrou model. As you can see, it works, but it is not perfect. Not sure why, but it seems that if you try to simplify it past a certain point, it completely messes with the 3D model. And after testing it with a couple of other 3D models, I noticed that this behavior happened with all of them. So I wanted to find a pattern in all of these cases. And after noting a couple of numbers and doing some calculations, I did find a way of limiting the error even if I don't really understand why. Here is me testing after using code to tell me the max value I can use to simplify the mesh. And with that out of the way, I simply had to add this functionality to my UI. I added a slider that would be used to increase or decrease the number of polygons. And well, after dealing with all of that setup, now look how many Hezrous I can put into the game without completely breaking it. Just as a side note, I coded a way to duplicate the object selected. That's why I can do this. With that, I feel confident that the VTT can move forward with the base idea I had from the beginning. Like this, it allows you to still import whatever you want, even if it isn't optimized for a video game, and the GM will be able to optimize the maps themselves. And since this devlog has been so focused on 3D models, you might have noticed that I have these models of a wolf, a tree, a dungeon entrance, and of course, a Hezrou painted already. And you might be wondering, what incredible artist painted them? And how? Well, I did. On Microsoft Paint 3D.
We don't make mistakes. We have happy accidents.
Because behind the scenes, I changed something. I changed the type of 3D model being imported into the game from .obj to .glb. This is because after messing a bit with MS Paint 3D, I found that the models painted there in that file format come with the model and the textures all in one file. So, unlike .obj's, there's no need to have an image file and an MTL file in the save folder, making the setup way cleaner and simpler, as well as MS Paint 3D being a software that every Windows user already has. And it is simple to use too. I also find it cool that this creates a direct counterpart to miniature painting in the real world. Now, if only I could implement a 3D model painter inside the VTT. I guess we'll see what the future holds in this, the Metas project.